Have you ever wondered how packets are transmitted from router to router and how encapsulation and decapsulation takes place from hop to hop in a data transmission to move data to its intended destination? Here's a quick anatomy of a data transmission, including all of the encapsulation and decapsulation and reading of headers that takes place along the way. When host A sends data to host B, each piece of data goes, as we say, down the stack. At each layer, a header is added. At the transport layer, a header with TCP or UDP ports is added. At the network layer, the source and destination IP addresses are added. In the data link layer, assuming Ethernet is used, the source MAC address and the MAC address of the next hop router is added. This destination MAC address is learned using ARP. Once that's done, the data with all its headers is placed on the physical medium as bits represented by voltages, electromagnetic waves, or light pulses depending upon the medium. When the data reaches the first hop, which is the default gateway of the local subnet, decapsulation takes place up to the data link layer. And there the destination MAC address is checked and read to ensure that the frame is intended for that next hop router. Once that's confirmed, it further decapsulates it and reads the destination IP address. It then looks that address up in the routing table, determines the egress port, and begins the encapsulation process again. This time it uses the MAC address of the egress interface as the source, and the MAC address of the next hop router as the destination MAC, again learned via ARP. Once it reaches the next router in the path, and every router after that, the same decapsulation, routing process, and re-encapsulation takes place. Once it reaches the intended destination, the destination MAC address is checked, and it's confirmed that it is indeed for the local device. Decapsulation takes place, the destination IP address is checked, and it is further decapsulated to check the transport layer header. There, the TCP or UDP port is checked, and based on that, the appropriate application is determined to receive and process the data. Once all the headers are gone, the original plain data is received and processed by the application itself. So in this whole process, the MAC addresses change from hop to hop, the IP addresses remain the same from end to end, and the TCP or UDP ports also remain the same throughout the transmission. For more telecom and networking simply explained, simply subscribe.